Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jay Mehta here from Mumbai, and in this video we will try and answer the most important question. Once a lady has been diagnosed with endometrial cancer, the common discussion in the family members is how do we get this treated? Remember, one thing is for sure, the treatment of endometrial cancer is to do surgery. This cancer usually affects the postmenopausal women. That means these are predominantly the women who are in their menopause, they have finished their childbearing, and it is extremely important to perform a surgical staging of endometrial cancer. Now, fortunately, the commonest type is the type 1 of endometrial cancer. We've discussed this before, and this is predominantly in women who are either obese or are diabetic or are hypertensive, and it is going to manifest with postmenopausal bleeding. Now, if enough attention is paid to this postmenopausal bleeding, the women are going to quickly go to their doctor. A biopsy is going to be performed based on the endometrial thickness, and you will have a biopsy proven diagnosis of the endometrial cancer. The technique of choice of performing the staging for endometrial cancer is laparoscopic surgery or keyhole surgery or minimally invasive surgery. Remember, there are great advantages to performing this technique with laparoscopic surgery. The commonest doubt or fear is that if we do with laparoscopic surgery, are we going to have a surgical completion? For people who do not do laparoscopic surgery, they try and counsel the patients by telling them that if you do the surgery through small holes or through a laparoscope, the disease will remain inside the body and the surgery will not be complete. But it has been proven without any doubts across the world that when an expert laparoscopic surgeon does the staging in cancer endometrium, obviously the surgeon who is well trained is going to get equivalent or even better results than doing open surgery. Laparoscopic surgery involves specialized skills and techniques of performing the staging of cancer endometrium. Apart from doing the hysterectomy, apart from doing the bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy, additional techniques like pelvic paraaortic lymphadenectomy and omentectomy may be indicated in these patients based on the nature and the grade of the disease which we have on the biopsy. It is also very important to understand from the patient perspective that when a laparoscopic surgery is done, the mobilization and the recovery time of the patient is absolutely rapid. Fortunately, we are a very high volume unit for cancer endometrium, and we perform more than 100 surgeries for cancer endometrium every year. And almost all our patients, irrespective of the comorbidities, irrespective of the obesity, they are usually discharged within 36 hours of the surgery. Now, fortunately, for an advanced center with all the facilities like the way we have, it's common that the patients have a fantastic recovery following the surgical exercise. It's vitally important that if a patient is diagnosed with cancer endometrium, they should consider the laparoscopic approach and try and go to the surgeon who is extremely capable or extremely trained in performing pelvic lymphadenectomies as well as staging surgeries for the best interest of the patient. Now, what is important to remember is that once the surgery is performed, we get a biopsy report approximately after 10 to 11 days of the surgery. This biopsy report is going to give you vital information. It is going to give you an idea of the actual spread of the disease, and that's the reason why it is called as a surgical staging. If the biopsy shows there is presence of tumor in the pelvic nodes, then typically these patients would require post-surgical chemotherapy as well as radiation therapy. If the pelvic nodes show that there is absence of cancer, that means they are free of cancer or they are free of spread of the disease, that marks the end of the treatment. Obviously, with any patient of any cancer, the most important thing is a good follow-up with your doctor. Your doctor will advise you a 3-monthly follow-up in the first year following surgery, and it is of utmost importance that patients and their relatives realize the importance of having a good follow-up with the doctor who has done your surgery. Fortunately, in our country, cancer endometrium is usually picked up at an early stage. When this disease is picked up at an early stage, the chances of recurrence are very low following a good surgery in an expert hand, and the life expectancy and the 5-year survival for this disease is extremely favorable. The only thing that is important is that the patient should not miss out on postmenopausal bleeding, should consider it as a warning sign, go to the doctor, get the treatment done from the right hands. Obviously, cancer endometrium is a big topic, a tedious topic. Should there be questions, you can post them in our comment box. Me or one of my colleagues will try and answer those questions as soon as we can. Thank you so much.